As twilight embraces the world and stars begin to twinkle in the night sky, it's time to unwind and journey into the land of dreams. In our cozy corner, stories await to whisk you away. Tales woven with magic, whispers of faraway lands, and echoes of ancient myths. Each story is a gentle lullaby, crafted to guide you towards a peaceful slumber. As our story begins, let your eyes grow heavy, your breath slow, and your heart find its peaceful rhythm. Remember, in the world of Get Sleepy Cozy, you're always safe, always cherished, and always just a dream away from magic. Now, let's turn the page to our story tonight. Close your eyes, breathe deeply, and let the adventure unfold in the theater of your mind. Now, let's begin tonight's tale. The Forgotten Library. The Ocean of Stars. Voyage to the Starlit Sea. After her enlightening experiences in the Shadowlands and her reflective journey through the Ocean of Stars, Zephyra Quill found herself standing before a new realm within the Chrono Codex. Her hand hovered over a book with a cover that shimmered like the surface of a tranquil sea under a moonlit sky. The title read, "The Island of Lost Memories." Intrigued and guided by her ever-present curiosity, she opened the book. Instantly, she was enveloped in a whirlwind of starlight, and when it dissipated, she found herself on the deck of a different vessel, one that seemed to sail not on water, but through a sea of stars. The ship, named the Memory's Voyage, was magnificent, with sails that glittered like diamonds against the cosmic backdrop. The captain of this vessel was a wise and aged sailor named Captain Orion, whose eyes held stories of countless voyages across the starlit sea. He greeted Zephyra warmly. "Welcome aboard, traveler. We are on a journey to the Island of Lost Memories, a place where the past, present, and future converge." Zephyra looked around in awe. The sea around them was a vast expanse of twinkling stars and nebulous clouds, creating a breathtaking tapestry of light and color. She could see distant galaxies and constellations, some familiar and others entirely unknown. As they sailed, Captain Orion shared tales of the Starlit Sea, a realm where memories took physical form and the stars themselves held the secrets of time. "The Island of Lost Memories," he explained, "is a sanctuary where memories lost to time can be rediscovered. But be warned, not all memories are eager to be found." Zephyra felt a mix of excitement and apprehension. The idea of exploring a realm of memories was fascinating, but she also understood the potential risks. Memories, especially lost ones, could be powerful and unpredictable. The journey continued, and soon, the Island of Lost Memories came into view. It was an ethereal place, its shores shimmering with a gentle light, and the air filled with the whispers of forgotten tales. As the ship docked, Zephyra stepped onto the island, feeling a sense of nostalgia wash over her. The landscape was dotted with ancient trees, their leaves shimmering with a luminescent glow, and streams that flowed not with water, but with liquid light. Zephyra knew that somewhere on this island lay the key to understanding more about the Chrono Codex and her role as its guardian. With determination, she began her exploration, ready to uncover the secrets held within the Island of Lost Memories. The Island of Lost Memories. As Zephyra ventured deeper into the Island of Lost Memories, the scenery around her began to change. The trees whispered in hushed tones. their leaves rustling with the echoes of forgotten stories. The path beneath her feet was lined with stones that glowed softly, lighting her way through the twilight realm. The air was thick with a sense of longing and nostalgia, as if the island itself yearned to remember its past. Zephira felt a connection to this place, a feeling that she was walking through the pages of her own forgotten diary. Soon, she came upon a clearing where a serene lake lay, its surface as smooth as glass and reflecting the starlit sky above. In the center of the lake was a small, luminescent island, accessible only by a narrow bridge of light. As Zephira crossed the bridge, she noticed that the air around her shimmered with faint images, like ghostly echoes of moments long past. These were the memories that the island held, fragments of time and emotion preserved in the ether. Reaching the island, Zephira found a stone pedestal with a book resting upon it. The book seemed ancient, its pages filled with writings in a language that felt familiar yet unrecognizable. She understood that this was the Book of Echoes, a compendium of the island's lost memories. As she touched the book, visions flashed before her eyes, memories not her own, yet imbued with deep emotions. She saw laughter and tears, love and loss, triumphs and failures, the myriad experiences that form the tapestry of life. Zephira realized that the Book of Echoes was a key to understanding the deeper connections within the Chrono Codex. It held the collective memories of countless souls, each a thread in the larger narrative of the realms. However, she also sensed a deeper, underlying current within the book. A memory that was trying to emerge, something significant and urgent. Zephira concentrated, delving deeper into the book's essence. Suddenly, a powerful memory surged forth, engulfing her. It was a memory of the Elders of Time, the creators of the Chrono Codex. She saw them in a grand chamber, weaving the fabric of the realms, their magic binding the books and worlds together. This memory was a revelation. It showed the purpose behind the Chrono Codex, a grand design to connect different worlds and experiences to preserve knowledge and understanding across time and space. As the vision faded, Zephira was left with a profound sense of awe and responsibility. She now understood that the Chrono Codex was more than a collection of realms. It was a living, breathing tapestry of existence. With this newfound knowledge, Zephira left the Book of Echoes, ready to continue her exploration of the island. She knew that each step brought her closer to understanding her role in the grand scheme of the Chrono Codex and the journey that lay ahead. The Celestial Whale and the Star Map. Continuing her exploration of the Island of Lost Memories, Zephira encountered an awe-inspiring sight. A colossal whale, ethereal and luminescent, gliding gracefully through the sky above the island. This was the Celestial Whale, a guardian of the island's memories and a guide to the secrets of the starlit sea. As the whale descended, the air around it shimmered with stardust, and its eyes, vast and wise, fixed upon Zephira. In its presence, Zephira felt a profound sense of peace and understanding. The Celestial Whale spoke in a voice that resonated like the deep chords of the universe. Zephira Quill, seeker of knowledge, you have journeyed far and discovered much. The Island of Lost Memories holds a key to the path you seek. With a gentle movement, the whale released a stream of light from its mouth, forming a map of the starlit sea in the air before Zephira. The map was a complex network of constellations and celestial pathways, each leading to different realms within the Chrono Codex. The map you see is a guide to the realms of the Chrono Codex, the whale continued. Each star represents a portal, a gateway to a world within the library. Your journey is not just about exploring these realms, but also about understanding the connections between them. Sephira studied the map intently, memorizing its intricate patterns and the locations of the various portals. She realized that this map was an invaluable tool in her quest to uncover the mysteries of the Chrono Codex and protect its realms. The celestial whale then imparted a warning. The realms are interconnected, and actions in one can ripple across others. You must navigate these pathways with care and wisdom, for the balance of the Chrono Codex is delicate. As the map dissolved into stardust, the whale began to ascend back into the sky. Zephyra felt a sense of gratitude and determination. The guidance of the celestial whale had provided her with a clearer understanding of her journey and the role she played in the grand narrative of the Chrono Codex. With the image of the star map etched in her mind, Sephira continued her exploration of the island. She knew that each realm she visited would bring new challenges and revelations. But she also knew that she was equipped with the knowledge and tools needed to face them. As the celestial whale disappeared into the starlit sky, Zephira felt a renewed sense of purpose. She was not just a traveler or a guardian. She was a weaver of stories, a connector of realms, and a keeper of memories. Her journey through the Chrono Codex was a journey of discovery, not just of the realms, but also of herself, a starlight farewell. Having restored the balance of the Island of Lost Memories and safeguarded the ocean's heart, Zephyra made her way back to the shore where the memory's voyage awaited her. The island, now radiant with a renewed sense of harmony, seemed to bid her a silent farewell, its whispers echoing with gratitude and recognition of her bravery. Captain Orion greeted Zephyra as she boarded the ship. "The island has been calmed and the balance restored," he observed, his voice reflecting both respect and a hint of wonder. "You have done what many believed impossible." As the memory's voyage set sail, leaving the island behind, Zephyra stood at the bow, watching the stars twinkle above and the sea sparkle below. The journey had been more than an adventure. It had been a journey of self-discovery and realization of her capabilities as a guardian of the Chrono Codex. Captain Orion joined her, his gaze fixed on the horizon. "The realms you visited, the challenges you've overcome, they're all part of a greater journey, Zephyra. The Chrono Codex is not just a collection of realms. It's a reflection of the universe and its endless possibilities." Zephyra nodded, her thoughts on the experiences she had gained and the lessons she had learned. "Each realm has shown me a different aspect of the Chrono Codex, and in turn, a different aspect of myself. I feel a deeper connection to the library and its purpose now." The ship sailed through the starlit sea, the journey back to the portal marked by a sense of tranquility and contemplation. The experiences on the Island of Lost Memories had given Zephyra a deeper understanding of the interconnectedness of the realms and the importance of her role in maintaining their balance. As the ship approached the portal back to the Chrono Codex, Captain Orion offered Zephyra a parting gift. A small luminous orb that contained a fragment of the starlit sea's essence. "Keep this with you," he said. "It will remind you of the journey you've taken and the path still ahead." Grateful, Zephyra accepted the orb, feeling its gentle warmth and the faint pulsation of its light. It was a tangible connection to the realms she had explored, and a symbol of the journey she was on. With a final look at the memory's voyage and the vast, starry expanse around her, Zephyra stepped through the portal. The familiar sensation of transitioning between realms enveloped her, and when it subsided, she found herself once again in the vast chamber of the Chrono Codex. The library welcomed her back, its shelves brimming with untold adventures and mysteries. Zephyra felt a renewed sense of purpose and determination. She was ready to continue her journey, to explore the remaining realms of the Chrono Codex, and to fulfill her destiny as its guardian. With the orb from Captain Orion in hand, and the lessons of the Island of Lost Memories in her heart, Zephyra stepped forward, eager to embrace the next chapter in her incredible journey through the realms of the Chrono Codex. Return to the Chrono Codex. Back in the Grand Chamber of the Chrono Codex, Zephyra Quill stood amidst the towering shelves of books, each a gateway to a different world. The orb from Captain Orion glowed softly in her hand, a comforting presence that connected her to the realms she had traversed. As she walked through the aisles, Zephyra reflected on her journey thus far. She had ventured through the enchanted forest, navigated the challenges of the Shadowlands, and explored the depths of the Ocean of Stars. Each realm had tested her in different ways, teaching her valuable lessons about courage, wisdom, and the intricate balance of the Chrono Codex. Her experiences had transformed her from a mere librarian into a guardian of worlds, a protector of the vast knowledge and mysteries contained within the library. She understood now that the Chrono Codex was more than a collection of books. It was a living entity, a microcosm of the universe with its own rhythms and secrets. As she pondered her next destination, Zephyra felt a sense of anticipation. The Chrono Codex still held many realms to explore, each with its own unique challenges and wonders. She was eager to continue her journey, to uncover more of the library's secrets and fulfill her role as its guardian. Zephyra's thoughts were interrupted by a gentle pulsation from the orb. It seemed to be guiding her towards a particular section of the library. Trusting her intuition and the guidance of the orb, she followed its lead. Her path led her to a book with a cover that gleamed like polished metal, its title reading, The Clockwork Kingdom. Intrigued and guided by the orb's subtle urging, Zephyra reached out and opened the book. Once again, she was enveloped in the familiar whirlwind of light and color as she transitioned between realms. When the sensation subsided, Zephyra found herself standing in a world unlike any she had seen before. She was in the heart of a vast mechanical city, where buildings were made of gears and steam, and the air was filled with the sound of ticking clocks and whirring machines. This was the Clockwork Kingdom, a realm where technology and magic intertwined, creating a landscape of wonder and innovation. Zephyra gazed around in awe, her curiosity piqued by this new world. The Clockwork Kingdom promised a new set of adventures and mysteries, and she was ready to explore its secrets. With the orb in her hand and the lessons of her past journeys in her heart, Zephyra Quill stepped forward into the Clockwork Kingdom, her spirit alight with the excitement of discovery and the resolve to continue her journey as the guardian of the Chrono Codex.